How many of you know scuba diving? No worries. Today I'm going to take you for a dive. Just imagine that you are in the Mauritius and waiting for a boat and take you for scuba diving. 5 years ago, I started my scuba diving journey. And I was in the Thailand waiting for my boat. It got 4 days. I'm a good swimmer. So I started thinking that, wow, this can be an easy ride for me. But what happened when the instructor started giving me the instruction about the gears, and I realized that there's a lot of physics required in the scuba diving. And he gave me all the things about the oxygen, how to use oxygen effectively, how to use the BCD, which is the biology control device, how to use a mask, and I was very excited to get inside the water. But the first setback which I had, when I put the oxygen into my mouth, and believe me, first thing I was thinking that I'm going to breathe using my nose, but he said never ever breathe using your nose, you have to breathe by your mouth. And the second thing I realized, when you get the fresh oxygen in your mouth, it's completely different. So I was mesmerized by that, and I did the first dive, and I came out and was thinking, okay, I think I should go for the next one. And I did the second one, and I completed my discovery dive. Suppose that I was so excited I wanted to do my open water, and now I'm an open water diver. So today I'm going to be a dive instructor and going to walk you through a dive, maybe place you choose it. But as a diver, I have a couple of things which I will talk to you. So good afternoon, Aftab Suloda, a scuba diver, IT professional, a father, a son, and a very obedient husband. So our dive starts in 5 minutes, and we'll get ready for that. I hope you all have got the gears and ready. And as a dive instructor, I want to make sure that your gears are well. And important thing is that because I'm a dive instructor, please be with me all the time while you're inside the water. So every 5 meters, we'll stop and take a deep breath, and then go down further. So and our dive is going to be discovery dive, just going to be 10 meters, and then we'll back in 10 minutes. So we are reaching now, started dipping into the water, the first 5 meter. Please take, relax, and start having some more oxygen in your work. Now in the first 5 meter, I want to talk about the problem. I always see problem out as an opportunity. And one of the important things which I've learned in my career is that how to embrace problem and convert those into the opportunity. And that was very interesting for me. I was told to take over a very interesting job into Philippines. And I was not knowing anything about Philippines. And I took that challenge because my team was wanting to grow the business over there. And it was really going to be a niche area which I had to explore. So I took the challenge and went there and started exploring that. The first thing I had to learn, the culture, the people. It was really devastating for me to get into there and then start building it. But I took the problem and converted this into opportunity, and today the business is flourishing over there. Okay. So I think we should start now sinking further, and we are going to stop at 7 meters. And again, we have to breathe slowly, and again, start using more in equalizer. Second, at the 7 meter, I want to talk about success to failure. And I have really lived the success to failure in my life. And if you see the graph which I've drawn over here, at times I've seen that the success to failure is like a heartbeat for me. If the heartbeat becomes straight, I think we are dead. So I embrace the success and failure. And at different point of my career and my life, I felt that when I have seen the failure in my life, I have actually gone a little bit higher in my success also. But a very interesting thing is I was in Singapore in 2003, and I was really doing well, but there was some point in my life where I felt that, okay, fine, it's not working well for me. And I wanted to move back to India. That was a big decision which I took, and because I was not doing well there, and I came back to India. And if I see that today, I'm really doing well over here. So that's really a success and failure story for me. I think we should start descending a little further down and hit the 10 meter where I can see the beauty of the sea. At the 10 meter, I want to talk about the risk. I really feel that if you don't risk, you risk more, and I have lived that. I'm actually a very ardent traveler also, and I've traveled almost more than 20 countries. And interestingly, I was in Johannesburg with my wife, and we were traveling back from the airport to the hotel. And I realized that we don't have the GPS. It's almost 8-9 years ago. And the GPS was not working, and we have to really make it our way back to the hotel. And somehow we have to start driving, and Johannesburg is not a very safe place. So we have to really make it up. We started calling our friends, and finally we reached the place, reached the hotel. So it was one of the areas which I felt that if I would have not taken the risk, I would have not made the hotel. I think the oxygen is running out. I have to go back to the surface now. So in the 5 meter, I want to make one more safety stop. And that's about the respect. I think I'm really proud to say that I've been respected across, and today I'm here in the Toastmasters. So thank you for the respect which you've given, and I'm here to in front of you. So coming back to the surface, I hope you enjoyed the dive with me, and we've talked about respect, risk, problem, and success to failure. Thank you so much.